The Maya are an ethnic group, which is to say a bunch of people that are connected by language and cultural affinities. This is not to say they speak exactly the same language. There are 30 living languages in the Maya family today. They're close to each other. They're as close as, say, Spanish and Portuguese, but they're also as different from each other as Spanish and Portuguese. The traditional home of the Maya is the Yucatan Peninsula and the adjacent parts of southeastern Mexico, northern Honduras, and El Salvador, including the entire country of Guatemala and Belize. The Maya, like indigenous peoples worldwide, have discovered that they can trade on their Mayanness. They're an oppressed people, they get the jobs no one else wants, and yet they've been able to hold on to their traditions by making things for tourists. This isn't to say that they make watered down or crappy versions of their indigenous art, although some people do, but they still make beautiful textiles and wood carvings, and they do ecotourism, and they have found that they have a connection that the rest of us desire, and that's what they trade on to save their culture. The Mesoamerican Classic period is called Classic because of the Maya, whom people compared to the Classic Greeks. From about 200 AD till about 900 AD, the Maya were at their cultural apogee. They built enormous, beautiful cities in the jungle. They erected towering sculptures and had a huge population, massive cornfields and canals and a great population. And the Maya, it turns out that actually before the Classic period, what we call the late pre-Classic, the Maya were pretty impressive as well, from the period of about 300 BC to 200 AD. But it was during the Classic period that what we think of as the Classic Maya dominated Mesoamerica. And unfortunately, like many great cultures, like pretty much all golden ages, they reached too far. They cut down too much of their forest. They destroyed their environment. They did the same thing as we're doing to our land and to our oceans. They used up too much of it, so they'd reached the carrying capacity of their land. And when a bad drought came, that was it. There was no way, no cushion, no backup, no way to sustain themselves through this terrible drought, which probably they had a succession of droughts, maybe lasting 5 or 10 years at a time. And they simply abandoned their cities. Their canals filled up with muck, the cornfields withered, the people went back to a simpler lifestyle. The Maya created a calendar that has brought them to our attention in this whole series, and brought this whole series to life, for that matter. And the calendar that they had was shared with the other peoples of Mesoamerica. And interestingly, the Aztec calendar has a beginning and an end. The Mixtec calendar has a beginning and perhaps an end. And the Maya calendar has a beginning and, some people believe, an end. But they're all different. And why should we believe the Maya calendar is any more accurate than the Aztec calendar, for example? In this series of videos, I want to examine some of the things that we know and things that we don't know about Maya culture and the Maya calendar and what they believe. If you like this video, there will be more. And if you really like this video, I've written a book about 2012, which I encourage you to look up.